Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by name. Thou art mine. When thou pass through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. God has said to you, some of your fears are irrational because I've promised to be with you in the midst of the difficulty that you are facing.
Amen.
You need to stop worrying about what others think about you, or even what you think about yourself, and start respecting and honoring God. And you need to stop being irrational about the fears that you've been worried about. Number two, God is a God of grace. We've seen here what Pastor was saying about we need to be obedient to get blessing, and that is so true. But then there's the other side as well, where we have a God of grace, a God of mercy. As Pastor said about the blood, I was watching the funeral of Billy Graham the other day, and his daughter said that when she was about 20, she went off to marry this guy, and it wasn't a good marriage. They warned her, don't get married to him. She got married to him. It was not a good marriage. And then she got married to another guy. They warned her, don't go with that guy. She went with that guy, and it was not a good marriage. That's two marriages messed up. Then she said, I was worried. I thought, if I go and see my mum and dad, the great Billy Graham and my mum, and I go and see them, they're just going to condemn me now. They warned me twice. I've messed up twice. So she said she went up the drive. They lived on a mountain. And she was going up the drive only in her 20s. She thought, I'm a mess. I've failed. That's it with me. My parents are going to condemn me. So she goes up the drive, and there her father, Billy Graham, was waiting for her, and he went up to her and he just hugged her and gave her a great big hug. And that's sometimes what we need. We do fail, we do make mistakes, but you need to know that no matter how many mistakes you have made, your father is your father.
Amen.
Your father is your father. And he loves you. It's so important in this passage. Because in this passage in Isaiah 41 verse 10, the context is that there were 100 years of disobedience, over 100 years of disobedience. The Assyrians came and invaded Jerusalem, invaded Judea. And the Jewish people were still not listening to God. They were disobedient. Then the Babylonians came and they took away captive the Jewish people. And the temple was left empty and the walls were knocked down and the people of God are now in captivity in Babylon. And Isaiah now is prophesying about the future during this captivity. One day they'll come out of captivity. And if you look at verse 7, Isaiah 41 verse 7, it says, so the carpenter encouraged the goldsmith, and he that smootheth with the hammer, and him that smote the anvil, saying, it is ready for the... I can't read, I'm getting old, folks. It is ready for the soldering, and he fastened it with nails that it should not be moved. So they rebelled in the time of the Assyrians. They rebelled now. They've been taken into captivity by the Babylonians. And it got so bad that there was a generation of young people that grew up in Babylon, of Jews, and they didn't want to go back home. They settled down, and when they settled down, they started to look to other false gods. That's what they're talking about here, nailing down false gods. And listen to this. In the midst of this disobedience, God says in Isaiah 41:10, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness.
Amen.
You've been a disobedient lot, but I am with you. I am going to bring you out of captivity, and I'm going to bring you home. And I'm going to bless you. They failed, they messed up, they made mistakes. But nothing could take them out of the love of their Father God, who loved them and who would keep them. And you're full of fear. Maybe you're full of fear because you've made mistakes. Maybe you've made mistakes and you think that you'll never ever see the blessings of the vision that you once had, of the dreams that you once had. You had dreams, you had vision, but you failed and you think, no, it's never going to be like it was before. It's going to be better than before, my friend. Because your God loves you.
Amen.
And every mistake that you've ever done, they made a lot of mistakes. But every mistake that you have ever done, even those mistakes, God was over it. God was with you. And God is going to bless you through them.
Amen.
And so we see in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8, for thy grace are you saved. You're saved by grace. For by grace you are saved. Through faith and not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. You were saved by grace. And it is grace that keeps you today. It is grace that unfolds you. It is grace that is with you. And you made mistakes and you failed, but grace covers you today. Your Father God loves you today. And your Father says, fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. I am going to bless you. I am going to guide you. I am going to use you. I have not forsaken you.
Amen.
I hold your dreams. I hold your future. I hold it. Not him. Not her. Romans 6:38, 39, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
You failed, you made mistakes, but stop condemning yourself. God does not want you to be down in fear anymore. He is your Father, and he's going to guide and bless you. He's going to take you from where you are, and he's going to take you to better places.
Amen.
Why? Because he's a God of grace.
Hallelujah.
He's a God of second chances, and third chances, and fourth chances, and fifth chances.
Amen.
And he's your God.
Amen.
God, your Father, has the last say on your life. Not you. You might say, it's all over. You might say, there's no future. They might say, it's all over. They might say, there's no future. But your Father says, I love you.
Amen.
And at the end of the day, your Father says, at the end of the day, you're my child. And Amen. You might have messed up, but you're my child. And you've learned from this experience. You've learned the hard lessons through this. You've learned, but my child, I love you. And I'm bringing you through this. And I'm taking you to better places.
Amen.
Next, realize, we've looked at realize how great God is. God's grace. Realize how great God is. So we've looked at the grace of God here. Now look at how great God is. You look at the stars with your naked eye. You might see a few stars. But when you get to a telescope, and you look at the telescope, and you see the expanse of the universe, and how many stars are there, your vision is expanding. You're discouraged about the situation, and you see the difficulties in your situation. And one of the things in your situation right now that you see, the words in your mind that come is this: this will never change. There's something in your life when you've said, I've tried, I've prayed, but this will never change. Let's have a look at the Word of God. Isaiah 41, you look at verse 1. Remember the picture of the stars, the vision of the stars, the telescope, getting a greater vision. We're now going to get a greater vision of who God is. Verse 1, Isaiah 41, verse 1. Keep silence before me, O islands. Let the people renew their strength. Let them come near. Let them speak. Let us come near together to judgment. So what is God saying there? He's saying, look. Come, nations, come. Let us judge the nations. That's what he's saying. Verse 2, Isaiah 41, verse 2. It says, who raised up the righteous man from the east, called him to his foot, and gave the nations before him, made him ruler over kings. He gave them as the dust to his sword, and has driven stubble to his bow. That's in reference to Cyrus. Cyrus, you have the Assyrian Empire, the Babylonian Empire, but God is going to send the Persian Empire, controlled by Cyrus, to deliver his people. So God's saying, look, I am the God who is going to raise up an emperor who's going to set you free. So he judges nations, he's over the nations. In verse 4, Isaiah 41, verse 4, who hath wrought and done it, calling, here it is, the generations from the beginning. I, the Lord, the first and the last, I am he. So your situation, you say it can't change. That situation in your life, it can't change. I've prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed. I've cried and cried. It will never ever change. God says to you right now, I'm the one that judges nations. I'm the one that raises up and pulls down nations. I am the God that makes nations.
Amen.
You're telling me that situation in your life can't change? I am the God who creates nations. And I can and will change that which you say cannot change in your life.
Amen.
Isaiah 41, verse 13. Isaiah 41, verse 8. Thou, Israel, art my servant, Jacob, whom I have chosen, the seed of Abraham, my friend. Notice the word servant there. The word servant has four different meanings in the book of Isaiah. It can mean servant as in a person serving. It can mean servant as in Israel. It can mean servant as in the Messiah. It can have a different meaning. But here the word servant means the people of Israel. So God is saying, look, I create nations, I judge nations, I'm over nations. But in the midst of all this control of nations, you are my servant. You are my people. You I have chosen. You I love. And God is saying to you today, in all the control of America and Africa and China, all the great control I have over the nations, you are important to me. You are the one that I saved. You are the one that I called. You are the one that I love.
Amen.
Isaiah 41, verse 13. For I, the Lord thy God, will hold thy right hand, saying unto thee, fear not, I will help thee. This God is saying to you today, fear not, I will help thee. I will help you as a wife, I will help you as a husband, I will help you as a mom, I will help you as a dad, I will help you as a leader, I will help you as a servant, I will help you.
Amen. Amen.
And number 4, finally, some practical steps to deal with fear. So let's just recap, just quickly. The Lord said, There's a right way to fear God, and a wrong way to fear, irrational fears. We've looked at that God is a God of grace, that they failed, they made mistakes, but yet God was with them. And you've made mistakes, I've made mistakes, but God is with you, He's with me. And then thirdly, we looked at, we realized how great God is. He's over nations. If He's over nations, that thing that you say can't change, can change. God is with you. And then finally, some practical steps to deal with fear. There was a chap, and he was walking along the road. He got attacked by some youth. So a few weeks later, he was walking near the area where he got attacked, and he wouldn't go near the area. He was frightened. And then from there, he thought, in fact, I don't even want to go out anymore. So from not going near that area, now he stays in the house. Then he wouldn't go in the front room. And then he wouldn't even get out of bed. He was full of fear, you see. Once you let fear in, it begins to shrink you. It begins to pull you down, and you begin to hide away from the world. And that's not God's will for you. Some practical steps to deal with fear. Number one, develop your relationship with God. 1 John 4, 18-19. There is no fear in love, but perfect love cast out fear, because fear of torment, he that feareth is not made perfect in love. We love him because he first loved us. 1 John 4, 18-19. There is no fear in love. Perfect love casts out fear.
Amen.
So spend time knowing your God. Spend time in relationship with him, and that will dissipate fear in your life.
Amen.
Number two, make a choice to trust God. You have a choice to listen to your fear, or you have a choice to follow God.
Amen.
It says, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee, that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Make a choice when fear comes to believe God. And then finally, stop reacting to your feelings and negative thoughts. Very often when fear comes in, we start to meditate on negative thoughts, and then we start to react to our emotions. Take control of your thoughts and dampen, and don't listen to your emotions. Confront them with the word of God.
Amen.
I will not be afraid of 10,000 of people, but thou hast set themselves against me and round about me. I will not be afraid of 10,000 of people. Psalm 3:6. He's meditating on the word of God, and he's not allowing his negative thoughts to get the better of him. He's not allowing his emotions to get the better of him. And so often we get discouraged, we get down, because we're too often thinking about that negative thought. That negative thought in your head, you keep thinking about it, and then your emotions get all gooey-wee-wee-wee-wee, and you follow your emotions, and then you're discouraged for a week, because you've let the mind meditate on negativity. You've let your emotions go with negativity. But God is saying to you, no. Start thinking scripturally. Meditate on your relationship with me. So we've come to the end. There's only 2 minutes now. Is that okay, Pastor? 2 minutes, yeah. I've been watching nature programs. And I watched a lot of hyenas chase a lion. Lions don't walk around fearful.
Amen.
They're bold. Amen. My message to you today is God wants you to be bold as a lion.
Hallelujah.
To shake off that fear, whatever that fear has been. Whatever it has been, however it has been, God is saying no. My will for you is to be bold as a lion.
Amen.
That's my will for you. Fear thou not, For I am with thee, be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with my right hand and my righteousness. Fear thou not as a wife, fear thou not as a husband, fear thou not as a mother, fear thou not as a father, fear thou not as a pastor, fear thou not as a servant of God, fear thou not.
Amen.
Be bold. Start to meditate on God, Isaiah 51, verse 1. Stop thinking about the problem and start thinking about the God over the problem. It says, hearken to me that follow after righteousness, ye that seek the Lord. Look unto the rock, whence you were hewn, unto the hole of the pit, whence you were digged. Look unto God. Excuse me. Look to God. Realize that God has your back. Isaiah 54, 4. Isaiah 54, verse 4. Fear thou not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither thou be confounded, for thou shalt not be put to shame. Thou shalt forget the shame of the youth, and shalt not remember the reproach of thy widowhood any more. Fear not, thou shalt not be ashamed.
Amen.
Realize that God has your back. That God is going to bless you. God is going to guide you. God is going to take you places you've never seen before.
Amen.
He's going to do it in your life because God's with you.
Amen.
And then finally, you turn to Psalm 18. I've written nearly all the scriptures down, but just one scripture that I've not written down. Psalm 18. Nothing is going to pull you down. Nothing is going to take you out. Psalm 18, verse 1. I will love thee, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler, in whom I will trust, my buckler, the horn of my salvation, and my high tower. I will call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised, so shall I be saved from my enemies. Come to the end. There's nothing to fear today. God is over you.
Amen.
He's round your side, and he's under you.
Amen.
Okay. You know, greatest thing that is strongest in this world is love.
Amen.
Love conquers even death. Amen. God has conquered death for you. His love goes with you today. But in the midst of his love, we just read that verse again. In the midst of his love, his word is his bond. I want you to take this last thought for you. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with my right hand of my righteousness. One thing that you can hold on today is the promise of God.
Amen.
It is an anchor to your soul. It is an anchor to your life. When everything goes wrong in your life, when everything seems against you, when you seem like giving in, when you say to yourself, it will never change, when you feel you've made a mistake, when you feel it's all against you, when they feel you're being criticized, when you feel you can't do it anymore, come back to this promise and hold on to it, and it will be like refreshment and renewal and jewel, and it will give you strength for the day, and it will come true in your life that God is with you.
Amen.
So you've nothing to be fearful of. So I want to see bold people today. That's my challenge to you today. No little whimpery kittens. I want to see bold lions.
Amen.
That's my challenge to you today, to Amen. Be bold. Nothing can take you out. Amen. God is with you.
Amen.
All is well. God bless you. I'll just pray. Father, forgive us when we're fearful. Forgive us when we want to creep and just lie in our beds and hide away from the world, Lord, because we can't cope. Lord, forgive us. Forgive us those times when we just can't go on, Lord, and we feel it's just will never change. And Father, forgive us, Lord. Expand our vision of the greatness of who you are. Fill us again afresh with your amazing love. Because you're a God who'll never leave us or forsake us. You're a God who always will be with us. You're a God who'll never forsake us. Father, we thank you that you'll never forsake us. We thank you that you're watching our back. We thank you that the God who is over the nations, who has them in his hands, is a God who chose us and a God who loves us and a God who'll never forsake us. Father, thank you for these amazing truths in your word. And Father, any person here today whose heart has been discouraged, whose heart has been broken, whose heart feels that, no, I'm full of fear, I pray whoever that person is today, that they might receive a treble blessing in their lives today. That the chains might be broken today in their life. That they might be set free today. That they might know that you go with them today. That they might know that you're going to bless them today. That they might know that nothing will ever take them down. That, Lord, you have their back. And that they don't have to condemn themselves. That, Father, you love them. You are their Father. And you love them. Be with them, Lord. Bless them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Clap to God. Clap to God.